Oh man, it's like jumping in a time warp. I mean, last time I was here, it's actually a place where I'm standing wasn't here. It didn't exist. It was an empty lot with just a tennis court, a track, and parking. So it's like I said, like a time warp, you know? Well, some of my favorite memories weren't even on the court. They were off the court, all the people I met and helped guide me to where I am today. The basketball stuff, most of the memories were just with my teammates. Playing in the old Paramount Theater was very special. I mean, just going in there and looking around, you feel an ambiance of how special of a place it was. Well, I mean, that's what they say. I mean, I was the point guard, but if it wasn't for the 15 guys every day, sweat, blood, sweat, and tears in practice, we wouldn't have made it where we were.
What was it like playing in an NCAA tournament game?
Oh, it was a dream come true for me. I mean, as a little boy, I was always had a passion for basketball, and I was taught at a young age the best basketball to watch is college basketball. You learn the most. They're the most dedicated. They're trying the hardest. And so since I was real young, I always watched NCAA tournaments. So I always dreamed about being there. So it was a dream come true. Oh, words can't express the feeling. They really can't. It's unbelievable.
I want to talk about our first inductee this year, because when I got to LIU, I'm here 17 years, and when I got here, our men's basketball program, you know, wasn't exactly going in the right direction. We had, you know, a mediocre team, and we had a point guard on that team who I noticed right away just worked so hard, constantly kept the same work ethic, win, lose, draw, no matter what, just busted his butt every day in practice. And I mean, talented player, great shooter. By the way, Dave Masciale, I owe you $9. Remember we had that shooting contest? Well, interest accrued daily. It's probably $3,000-$4,000. I couldn't pay you back then because it would have been a violation, but I got you. But when I tell you, this guy was not just the heart and soul of the first three teams that he was the point guard for, but we got really good, really fast in the 96-97 season. We had an all-star team. We were the darlings of New York City basketball. We played in the NCAA tournament. We gave Villanova, who's one of the top teams in the country, that had four NBA players, we gave them a scare. And we had a number of players on that team that received a lot of notoriety. But you're going to have to trust me on this. And you could ask any of the people, Danny O'Connor, Margaret Alamo, Matt Scali, some of the people, and John Suarez got here like towards the end of that. Ask anybody who was here during that period, and they will tell you the same thing, that Dave Masciale, the point guard on those teams, was as important, if not more important, than any other player on that team. He was the heart and soul, he was the leader, he was the quarterback, he did it all. He was one of our leading scorers for 3 years. He realized the talent he had around him as a senior, and then became more of a distributor, more of a facilitator. Very, very unselfish guy. His numbers, I'm not a numbers guy, and he'll be the first to tell you he's not a numbers guy, but his numbers kind of speak for themselves. Over 1,500 points, over 250 rebounds, and Dave, what are you, 5'10 maybe? 5'10, 250 rebounds, and over 500 assists. One of six players in the history of the Northeast Conference to have 1,500 points, 250 rebounds, and 500 assists. Just a terrific, terrific, all-around, hard-nosed player. And it's my pleasure, and I know you know, you're probably not crazy about batting leadoff, but if you don't mind, Dave, I'd like to call you up. Dave Masciale.
I'll try to. Can I leave this up here? There we go. I think I have something in here. Promise I'll make this short and sweet. Greg, thank you very much. Wonderful introduction. Always been a great guy. And Greg actually started my junior year. We talked about it, junior year here. And he does tremendous, tremendous thing for the athletic program here. Tremendous. I first want to start by saying congratulations to all the inductees, the Hall of Fame class of 2013. I'm blessed not only to be inducted into the Hall of Fame, but to share this day with you. I was thinking earlier I would just walk up here, say thank you, and just be on my way, but there's way too many people to thank for this. Way too many. First, I'm honored to be in the Hall of Fame here at Long Island University. To have my name mentioned with such great company and great coaches, administrators, and athletes, such as Hall of Fame coach Claire B., coach and administrator Buck Lay, a great professor of mine, an outstanding coach, Rosalind Beck, soccer coach Artie Ramirez, O.C. Scheckman, first player in NBA history to score a basket, Luther Green, Ed Doc Turner, Ed Clark Flake Johnson, Freddie Burton, teammate Joe Griffin, friend and one of the best women basketball players I ever watched, Jania Butler, Stephanie White, the most fantastic softball pitcher to ever wear an LIU uniform, and all the past inductees is truly unbelievable, and there are no words to describe the emotions that I'm having right now. Thank you to the Hall of Fame committee for choosing me to be a part of this elite fraternity. Thank you, Athletic Director John Suarez, Margaret Alamo, Greg Fox, and the rest of the athletic department who have transformed Long Island University athletics from a 12 by 15 foot weight room right here in this building underneath us to one of the largest projects in campus's 78 year history, the $45 million, 114,000 square feet Wellness Recreation Athletic Center, which opened in 2006. Special thanks to an athletic department who in those years have at least 25 team championships in multiple sports, and countless other athletes have won individual titles. The list can go on, and I'm proud to call LIU my alma mater. I would like to thank all the coaches who've guided me, believed in me, and pushed me to the limits of my potential. Men like Joe Palamo and Paul Lizzo, my first head coach here at LIU. If it wasn't for these two men, give me the courage to recruit me and give me a shot, I wouldn't be standing before you here today. To Coach Ray Haskins, for not only getting the most of me as a player during my 2 years with him, but also teaching me how to represent myself as a man. Thank you to all my assistant coaches I had here for your time, energy, dedication, and hard work. Thank you to Coach Ken Tavani, our strength and conditioning coach during that time, for all the help of keeping the team strong and fit and pushing us to compete at the highest level. Especially thanks to Saeed, Dan O'Connor, and the rest of the athletic training staff for keeping the team healthy throughout the years. Now to all the men that I shared this rectangle right here where we sit with, all my teammates. This Hall of Fame honor really belongs to those guys more than it does to me. Michael Jordan once said, talent wins games, but teamwork and intelligence, that wins championships. This statement is what our team believed in. Well, maybe not the intelligent part, but definitely the teamwork. With teamwork, you can achieve anything you want, any game, any championship, any dream. And I'm eternally grateful to every one of those for helping me achieve one of my dreams on the night of March 6th, 1997, a Northeast Conference championship, the pitcher Greg talked about earlier, and a trip to the NCAA men's basketball tournament. As I look around here tonight, most of you were here that night, sitting right here. And what a night it was. However, that night, wouldn't have been made history if it wasn't for the men who gave their all. Hard work, every day in practice, in games, in that same 12 by 15 foot weight room, and the most important part, in the classroom. Men like fellow Hall of Famer Joe Griffin, my backcourt mate and brother at the time, still to this day, Sean Brown, physical education classmate and great friend Jason Cragen, my first roommate, who's here tonight, Jason Feely, Mike Campbell, Charles Jones, Richie Parker, Johnny Drew, Matt Picnic, Corey Goodall, Robin Dickinson, Kareem Smith, Omar Nardine, who was a walk-on, by the way, came out our junior year. Most people don't remember him, but he will always be in here. Anthony Linton, Dave Edabangio, Van Brown, and Steph Thomas. These men I will never forget. During my 6 years here, I say six because I continued to go on as a master, to get a master's degree, not because it took me 6 years to get an undergrad. I just want to make that point. I met a lot of people who helped mold me into the professional, educator, coach, and father I am today. From the coaches and teammates I already mentioned, professors and deans, to people that worked in the food service, security guards, janitorial staff, everybody. These people and countless others helped the lucky kid turn into the man that you see stand here today. A man appreciates his role as a teacher and a father. I would like to mention my family that is here tonight. My two grandparents, 86 years old and 84 years old. My mother, my siblings, my nieces and nephews. My mother-in-law, Maria, and friends for all your love and support throughout the years. You've always been my number one fans and the best supporters a player could ever have. To my lifetime teammates, Vanessa, and my two beautiful daughters, Victoria and Valentina. I live every day of my life for you. I don't know how I made it through the first 30 years without you. You girls are my heart and soul, and I love you very much. My journey at LIU started in the fall of 1993 as a young 18-year-old boy from Bayonne, New Jersey, with a passion to play the game of basketball. I didn't know what to expect or even if college was for me. I remember begging my brother Anthony, if you have time, you can come over and ask him. I said, don't take me back the first weekend. I don't want to go back. I don't think it's me. He told me, just wait until basketball season. Don't worry, Dave, it's going to get better. It's going to get better. My brother was wrong a lot of times in life, but boy, was he wrong now. We won 3 games my freshman year, 3-27. And after that, I was really ready to quit school. I was done. Just give it up and go home. Then I met the most intelligent, distinguished, and devoted person I will ever know in my lifetime. If you don't know who I'm talking about, you don't know LIU Brooklyn. Since 1989, this woman has transformed a campus that nearly closed its doors to a university that is now the heartbeat of downtown Brooklyn. When I think about this woman, I can't help but think of a quote from Maya Angelou. If you find in your heart to care for someone else, you will have succeeded. And succeeded she has by touching every student that steps foot on this campus. Provost Gail Stevens-Haynes, your caring, hard work, and dedication to the students of this outstanding university has translated my success and the success of countless individuals who have walked through these doors. My introduction into this Hall of Fame is a true testimony of your perseverance and commitment to excellence. I can only hope that one day I touch the heart and change the lives of an individual the way you have changed mine. In an article once written for the Network Journal, for the most influential black woman in history, Provost Haynes joked, "I am the only woman I know with 11,000 children." Well, Provost, let me just say how fabulous you look for having so many children. On behalf of the 10,999 siblings I have, I just want to say thank you for always believing in us, and we love you. Before I step down, I would just like to once again say congratulations to my fellow inductees who I share the stage here with tonight. I would like to acknowledge all the people in my life who have helped me achieve this accomplishment and put me into this Hall of Fame. Without all of your love, support, teaching, guidance, and understanding throughout the years, I wouldn't be standing here before you. I take a piece of each and every one of you into the Hall of Fame with me today. Long Island University will always be in my heart. Thank you, and in true LIU fashion, go Blackbirds.